What's up? Today I would like to talk a little bit about mouthpieces and what I play, what you should play, and if you're a beginner, what you should start on. Start by saying there's no right or wrong in this matter. Mouthpieces is very individual, and especially for me, I started on I think it was a Schilke 59, and then I went on to buying I think I've been through 15 or 20 different mouthpieces, so don't worry, I will try and sort everything out in this video. I would like to talk a little bit about my own mouthpieces first, and I mean, today this is my big strumming one, and today I play a Lasky 85 MD, and that's actually the one mouthpiece I keep coming back to. Like I said, I tried a lot of different stuff, but for me the Lasky is good. When I play large bore tenor, I do switch a little bit, but on a normal day, if I just play, you know, standard stuff, I play a Schilke 52. I do have some other pieces, but it just works for me. On my bass trumpet, I do have a custom Ledge mouthpiece. Of course, it's a Ledge bass trumpet, so it just fits very good. On my contrabass trombone, I also have a Ledge mouthpiece, and it's the Pfeiffer model. I don't generally like big mouthpieces, so also I don't consider this a big mouthpiece. It's not a deep mouthpiece. So also on the contrabass, I have a smaller, I think it's a 29.5 millimeter, and it's a fairly shallow cup. When you go out and try mouthpieces, you should just try a bunch. Borrow from friends, borrow from your teacher, borrow from professional players. I think it's a very important aspect of finding a new mouthpiece. It's I really think you should try different pieces and decide. And once you decided on a really, really good piece, like I did with this, I think it's very important when you find a new piece, a new mouthpiece, that you stick with it. And when I mean stick with it, I don't say like a week or 2 weeks. It's more like half a year, like 6 months or more. I think for me, I need at least 5 to 6 months to adjust completely to a new mouthpiece. And still this day to day, I think I learned some new stuff on the Lasky. I think it's quite important. Most people just throw out new stuff because it doesn't work after a week, but you know, daily grind and just keep at it. I do have some recommendations about beginner mouthpieces, and I have like two rules, is especially on tenor and on bass, don't go too big. I think it's very important that special bass trombones, when they want to have a new mouthpiece, the first thing they do is going out and buying a 0G or a Schilke 60 or something, and I think it's too big. If you start on bass, I think you should go for a 1.5G. It could be from Bach, it could be like a Schilke 58, I think. It's the same size. It could also be Wedge, Greg Black, Doug Elliott, Yamaha. Yamaha has also very good mouthpieces. But again, don't go too big. And if you're new, don't go too expensive. I think it's a key point. On tenor, I would go for a 6.5 AL. You can also go for 6.5 AL in Yamaha or Bach or whatever, but I think that size is pretty, I think it's pretty good. And best of all, it's really, really cheap, because you can buy them secondhand in stores, because it's, especially back in the days, it was the standard mouthpiece. So all trombones came with 6.5. So just a quick recap of the what should I buy, how should I buy it, or whatever. It's the most important thing is trying different stuff. I think it's very important to try different stuff, and at least for me, I finally realized that there's no such thing as a perfect mouthpiece. And I'm sorry, I'm really sorry. At least not for me. Either it's really good in the high register, really good in the low, it has great articulation or great sound. Mostly I can find 3 out of 4. And this has really good articulation, really, really, really good high register, really good low register. But the sound, sometimes I need to struggle with it. And I mean, it's fine. You get used to it and you work. Another important thing is listen to your teacher and listen to yourself. If your teacher says you need to switch, I think it's a relatively good choice to switch. But also listen to yourself. I think it's really important you listen to yourself, because at least for me, if I have a friend that switched to a new mouthpiece, I want to switch too. And I think it's really important to just to, am I happy with the gear I have now, and is it okay? Because most of the time it is okay. You don't need all the new fancy stuff. I mean, this mouthpiece is 6 years old and I love it. I still love it today. Of course, you know, buying a lot of gear is fun and trying out new stuff is fun, but I think it's important you take a step down and maybe invest the money into new books, like etude books, or use the money. I mean, mouthpieces are expensive. Use the money to take out of town and take a lesson, take two lessons. I mean, a custom brick bag is what, $350? I can get 5 lessons for the same amount of money. I would like to say thank you for watching this video, and if you would like to see more videos like this on different topics, like more gear, maybe my country based trombone and other stuff, subscribe to the channel, and hopefully with my new gear, especially my new Sony camera, there will be more content more frequently. And yeah, hope you enjoyed. Take care.